Yes, today is my defense day, the final day for my PhD. I will present it in a few hours in the afternoon, and I'm very happy, even though I'm very stressed today. With a little bit stressed, I'm so fine, so I'm very happy to present today. My PhD is in later Stone Age lithic technological behavior in the main Ethiopian rift. This is a lithic analysis between the two basins, Lake Peseka Basin and also Zuayshala Basin LSA sites. As you may know, we had old excavation in the Peseka Basin, which was excavated by Desmond Clark and also Steve Brandt. And also now we have recent excavation in Zuayshala Basin, along with you, François Bonne. So I make a little comparison between the two basins of the LSA sites. And I think it will be a very nice dissertation, I hope, at the end of the day. This PhD was greatly supported by the French Embassy and the Ministry of Foreign Affairs in Addis Ababa, and also by the ANR of Big Dry Project here in Toulouse, and also by ARCCH from the National Museum of Addis Ababa. So it is a combination of the Ethio-French research and also teams for this PhD, and I'm very happy with that. It is a long history that the French started to study the prehistoric sites in Ethiopia. It was since 1929, I guess. After that, there was a lot of historical research and also prehistoric research in the northern Ethiopia and also in the southern and central Ethiopia. My first encounter with a French archaeologist was in 2009, when I was the first employer. I'm not the first, the fresh employer of the National Museum of Ethiopia. I made a fresh excavation with Jusom, Roger Jusom, in southern Ethiopia with the megalithic site. So at that time, what I was learned was, I don't have at that time that much archaeological knowledge, but when I see the burials buried with that of the lithics, it was very interesting for me why these things happen in the historic and prehistoric period. So I became very interested with the archaeology of Ethiopia, especially that of the prehistory archaeology, the lithics part of the country. So I became to work involved with the French archaeologists, with you in 2012, and also the LSA project directed by you, François Bonne. So it became a very nice opportunity to expand my research interest in the prehistoric research of the country. So yeah, it was 2012 since I started to involved with the French, and then since 2016, at the end of 2016, with the support of the embassy and also with the support of the LSA project, I joined Toulouse University to be the doctoral candidate. And today, I'm going to defend my PhD. Yeah. It was a kind of 8 months research in France and also parts of the months in Ethiopia, like 4 or 5 months. So the idea is, to allow me to work more laboratory work in Ethiopia. If I stay like 4 months and 5 months in Ethiopia, it will give me a great opportunity, time opportunity, to analyze my materials. And the scholarship basically is like every year, 8 months stay in Toulouse. In fact, 8 months is by itself, without family, is very difficult. But thank you to the Big Dry project, I have time to fly back to Ethiopia during this time to work the laboratory, and also again to work to meet my family. So during these 4 years, I would say that I stayed here in Toulouse like 35 months totally within the 4 years, and the rest I stayed in Ethiopia for my laboratory work. So it is really fine to me. Fortunately, my child was born when I started my PhD in the first year. In the first year, it was a very difficult time because I was not able to be with my wife most of the time, to be with her and just to help her and also just to show her affection. And finally, I was not there in the birth of my son, but luckily now he's now 3 years old, more than 3 years old, and he's a product of this PhD after all. When I was in high school, I was very fascinated by the history of Ethiopia, basically. We know we have enormous resources of Ethiopian history, historical archaeology, but I don't know about prehistory at that time. But when I came to ARCCH in 2008, I faced different archaeological sites and also different archaeological collections. I said, whoa, it's not only history, we have also prehistory. So I would say that the first year I became very interested is in 2009. I think, when I see a lot of prehistory collections, such as that of the oldest stone tools from the Gona and other sites. So I become very interested with 98% of our prehistory. So it was in 2009. And it was also a great opportunity to work in the ARCCH by itself. Because when I work in the National Museum, I become very, very much fascinated, interested about the prehistory journeys and the prehistory research in the country. Therefore, it is late, in fact. It is only in 2009 since I become very interested. Before that, I was only in the history of Ethiopia and so forth. What I'm expecting in the future to work in Ethiopia is to continue working in the later storage period in Ethiopia with you and also all the French colleagues here in Toulouse, because we know that later stone age in Ethiopia is not really known. Even my PhD is not really enough to conclude the history of later stone age in Ethiopia. So I have a vision to work broadly in Ethiopia and to make a lot of survey and also to make a lot of test excavation in the different sites, not only in the main Ethiopian rift, but in different rock shelter sites in the country. That is how we can make a broader spectrum of the later Stone Age period in the Horn of Africa. As a wife, our research is not really, at this time, enough to conclude that it is this period is done and we finished. So I am planning to work with French colleagues and a lot of international researchers in Ethiopia and also in the other part of the world. It is a great opportunity to meet a lot of people from Western Africa and also from Eastern Africa, because, you know, Africa is a land, a vast land, and we are not really connected, to be honest. There is West Africa, there is East Africa. We don't know what's going on in West Africa, and they don't know what's going on in the research spectrum of East Africa. So I found the University of Toulouse a very good arena that connects us with Ghanaian friends, also with Chad friends, and with Djibouti friends, working in the historical archaeology and in the prehistory. So I think in the future we have to create a good platform that we can work together and we can share knowledge between East and West Africa on the prehistory, on the history of Africa. And I find it, Toulouse is, in the last 4 years, it is the best place that we are exchanging our knowledge with our African friends. Unfortunately, this year was a bit very stressful year and very challenging, as you know, because of this global health crisis, and again, unfortunately, it was my last year, and I have to finish writing my thesis. So it was very challenging, you know, to work in very confined area for very long, and without talking with people, and with a lot of fear going outside, and it was really very challenging. And at the same time, it is also a good opportunity because if I focus on my PhD, because I am grounded at home and I don't go out that much, and I just focused on my PhD writing for my thesis. I sometimes wonder if there is not such confinement, maybe I will be a little bit, you know, going outside in a little bit, but it will be a little bit, you know, opportunity for you know, to be confined, not the virus, but to be confined and work. At the same time, sometimes it is really boring and it's very challenging, yeah. I want to thank you, Francois Bon, and it is all because of you that I'm reaching and Kilosa Minard, of course, Kilimwa Minard, for reaching this day and also for even directing me to work in the later Stone Age research and problems in Ethiopia, and for enlightening me different perspective. You know, I learned a lot from you, the work, how you work things and how you manage things. And it is quite a lot of experience, not only the PhD, in fact. So thank you very much, everybody in the Big Dry team, and also Clément Minard, François Bon, and also, I'm not going to mention everybody, but thank you very much for all supports. It is curiosity, you know. I have a bit curiosity since 2009 on the prehistory of Ethiopia. So unless you have known, you have the knowledge of the past, how can you understand what are you going to do in the future? So you have to connect the past and the future to work better. So for me, it is a business, it is a knowledge, and also it is identity of humanity. Of course, it is very difficult to inculcate my knowledge of prehistory to this young generation, because in Ethiopia, people do not know that much about the prehistory, but they know very well about the history. Therefore, I think I have to want to say for these people that prehistory and history is very connected, and it is all about the history of the people, and archaeology is all tell us about this human past departure. Therefore, we have to understand our past to understand the future, and also to tackle our problem in Ethiopia in the present time. In terms of lytics, there is quite a lot of books, but for me, it is The Prehistory of the Horn of Africa, written by Desmond Clark, is one of the oldest book. But it tells us, it just depicts us a good picture of the Horn of Africa archaeological sites, prehistoric archaeological sites of the time. So Clark's book is better for me.